Hi, I'm Gaz, and I'm on a mission to train martial arts in every country in the world. So far, I've trained at 48 gyms in 7 countries, exploring the culture, meeting new people, and of course, training martial arts along the way. This episode is all about the island vibes of KOH TAO. Watch along for beautiful beaches, epic viewpoints, and loads of Muay Thai training. Don't forget to hit subscribe to come along on the journey.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome back. And today I'm checking out Island Muay Thai, and it's literally 2 minutes from my hostel. Really excited, up bright and early as all the classes seem to start at 8 a.m. So let's go.
The Island Muay Thai gym is located in the heart of Sirei Beach and offers group sessions twice a day. The gym is more on the basic side of Muay Thai facilities, even for Thailand, but still has everything you need.
Good start so far. Although there's 5 or 6 people in the class, looks like I'm the only Farang or Westerner, but trainer's super friendly, everyone's cracking on, and yeah, so far so good.
I was happy to be on the bags for the first few rounds for 2 reasons. Firstly, it helped me loosen up my hips, which felt surprisingly stiff. But more importantly, I'm currently working on improving my kicking technique, so dedicating the next few rounds for this was exactly what I needed. I spoke to Krumay about this, and pad work was focused on creating angles with punches to set up my kicks and turning my hip over on my right kick. The pad work struck a perfect balance between honing my technique and building conditioning, and we had good synergy and rhythm on the pads.
I've just done 3 grueling rounds on the pads with Krumay. I think it's definitely hotter in the islands, and this gym essentially is covered by like 1 metal tin across, so now the sun's come up, it's absolutely scorching. The pad work rounds were super technical, but still, as you can tell, I'm absolutely dripping in sweat, my lungs are busting, and now I'm going to jump onto some sparring with Krumay.
Sparring was technical and controlled, with Krumay letting me work, but every now and then he'd dig me with a body shot to let me know who's boss. None of my training partners were sparring, but in my second class at the gym, I had some really good rounds with some other trainers and fighters who were visiting.
Man, that was bloody tough rounds with Krumay. He was saying he fought last week and fights once a month either in KOH TAO, Bangkok or Chiang Mai. But yeah, he was just playing around with me, obviously, as usual. But still good to get the rounds in. And I'm sure I've got some kind of horrific fitness exercise coming to me next, which, yeah, not looking forward to.
The lesson I learned at the Island Muay Thai gym was don't judge a book by its cover. Whilst the gym was basic, it had really good vibes and high level training, which is everything you need for a Muay Thai session in Thailand. Overall, Island Muay Thai gym gets a thumbs up from me. After training, I spent the afternoon chilling on the beach, but this is my 4th time visiting KOH TAO, so here's my top 5 things I recommend that you do. Number 1 is a snorkeling trip, possibly the most popular thing to do on KOH TAO due to the epic coral and dive spots. Number 2 is the Queen's Cabaret, this is a really fun night out you don't want to miss. Number 3 is Sirei Beach, this is the heart of KOH TAO and this is the best place to grab a sunset beer. Next is Tanok Bay, this beach is more chilled and there's a massive rock in the ocean for cliff jumping. And finally, number 5 is the John Suan viewpoint. You can capture KOH TAO's beauty from the breathtaking views at this viewpoint.
Sawadee kap.
So hello everybody and welcome back to absolute island paradise on KOH TAO. Today I'm checking out the next Muay Thai gym, which is called Pankon Muay Thai. Now I haven't been training over the last couple of days. I've had a bit of a sickness bug, so I've been completely written off, just essentially either in bed or chilling on the beach. But I'm excited to get back on the saddle and get a session in today. They actually do a fight night here as well. You can see the ring and all of the chairs, which is really cool because I think like 5 or 6 years ago in KOH TAO, there weren't any fights, but you do once a month here?
Yeah.
Cool. Absolutely f***ed as well. I've got my Muay Thai shorts, but I've just realised I'm wearing swimming shorts from the beach and I've got no pants on underneath, so there's no way I could put these on. Absolute nightmare.
The warm-up started with nothing unusual, just some standard skipping, but the stretching was horrific. My trainer pushed and twisted me into some pretty strange positions, and as somebody who isn't that flexible, it was more painful than anything else. I did feel a bit looser afterwards, but this is definitely not my preferred method of stretching. Pad work was really intense, and my trainer constantly pushed the pace by throwing strikes back, sweeping me, or making me double up on all of my kicks. Some sessions you learn a lot technically or work on an aspect of your Muay Thai you need to improve, whilst in others you have to dig deep and just focus on your breathing and push through the session. Take a guess what was the case for me today.
These shorts are really pissing me off. I've done the first round of pad work and like honestly, they're so tight I can hardly kick. I can open my legs up or open my hips up even less than usual. So yeah, that's pissing me off. But apart from that, I think I'm just still getting over this flu. I was feeling better this morning, but obviously a couple of days off, absolutely gassed. One round in, I'm like, what have I signed myself up for? I know I'm gonna feel good after, but right now, I'm tempted to fake an injury. Just like grab my knee. Man, those were the most horrific 3 rounds of Muay Thai I've done in a long time. Oh, good training, but fuck, I'm fucked. Yeah.
100,
two times. Yeah. 100, one time, and break.
Yeah, then 100, one
time, break. Yeah. So just had a proper decent session with Krudong. Really, really good trainer and proper funny guy. He said if you want to train with him, just come in and ask for the handsome coach and they'll know who to give you. But yeah, really good guy. I'd say it was more on the kind of cardio, lung busting side than technical side. Definitely what I needed. Highlighted how unfit I am. I probably need to sort my shit out, stop smoking so many cigarettes, partying all the time and eating crap food, and really to commit to the challenge of training martial arts in every country in the world. Because essentially, if I keep going as I am, I won't make it. I'll end up dying beforehand. Anyway, I'm gonna go back now, chill, try and recover, and I'll catch up with you tomorrow where we're gonna check out the last Muay Thai gym on the island that we haven't visited yet.
I planned to show you Monsoon Gym, but unfortunately, my flu returned, so I had to take a few more days off training. I did get a chance to train there in 2019 and 2022, so I can highly recommend the gym. Overall, if you're looking for beautiful beaches, amazing island vibes, and a choice of decent gyms, then you need to visit KOH TAO. Make sure you like and subscribe, and come back for next week's video, where I'll be heading to Cambodia to explore Kun Kumir.